What's up, y'all? It's Demajani, and it's time for another one. So today we're going to be talking about this article I found here on SYFY Wire, and it's about the episode 9, aka Plan 9, for our future upcoming Star Wars movie that we don't know the title yet. But it was an interview with Oscar Isaac, and the title of it is Oscar Isaac Promises a Looser Feel to Star Wars Episode 9. So, this goes along the line with what I was talking about earlier, how it just really seems like they are just really, really flying off the seat of their pants with this movie. Like, seriously! Because no plan is like their only plan. They're throwing everything they can at this movie. They're allowing improvisation in there, which I kind of thought that's what they got rid of Lord and Miro for. Not sure, maybe I might be wrong, but you know, it's JJ, so I guess he's gonna be able to do the right thing, right? I don't know about that. I really don't. So let me just take out a quick little spot of what he says here, and this is the actual original interview was from IndieWire. And this is quoting Mr. Isaac here. It says, "The way they've been shooting it right now is looser than it's been for the last two times. It does feel like a relief to get on set and feel like, oh, we can try things. It is a testament to JJ coming back and feeling confident. There's less pressure for it to be right. We just want to make a good movie and have a really good time while doing it." I mean, that would be fine if you weren't doing damage control right now. If it was, hey, we're wrapping up the trilogy, we knocked it out of the park, we had $2 billion movie sales both times, we didn't have any of these agenda-driven stuff, and everything's going great, I could say, you know what? Have at it, Hoss. Just chill out. Get the movie done. You know, wrap up the Skywalker saga, which, again, like I said, this has not really been a Skywalker saga movie, to tell you the truth. This has been the Rey Nobody saga, and I really don't care if she's a Skywalker at this point. So, I mean, and Kylo Ren is a Solo, you know, even though he's of the Skywalker descent. But, you know, whatever. This has not been a Skywalker saga. So, you know, if that... had that been the case, it was just, you know, we got this thing ready. We know it's going to knock it out the park. We're going to do another $2 billion. So you have $6 billion total off the trilogy. I'll say, fine. Go a little improv. You know, have what you got to do. But for me, it just seems like by them not having a plan, and you're seeing that with the decisions that they're making, the not having a plan thing has been apparent since day one. Because I'm not going to go through the same stuff we always go through, but you can just see the track record. They're not having a plan. But this now is saying, you know what? The plan we have, don't worry about that plan. We're still just going to do what we want. We're just going to basically keep throwing stuff against the wall and see what happens. Because to me, when you talk about improv, that's kind of like what you're doing. I mean, obviously, there's a skill to it. But, you know, again, it doesn't give me confidence in this movie. It doesn't. It really does not give me confidence in this movie. And like I said, I want this movie to be good. The problem is that at this point in time and going forward, you can't fix this trilogy for me. I'd rather the next movie be made, the next set of trilogies be made by the guys from Game of Thrones. They need to do something away, like totally away from the six movies. Well, technically nine movies now. The nine movie, you know, Skywalker saga, you know, even though the last three weren't, but they have to do something totally different. Like, you know, either go in the future or go in the past. Just stay away from this. Like, the whole Battle of Yavin chunk of stories needs to go away. Like, all that needs to go away. Just, you made that bed. It's been terrible. Let's just move along. Let's wrap this up. Hopefully it's good. Like I said, I am I don't want to see this movie, but I will probably go see it for you guys just to, you know, give my opinion on it for the channel. That's basically the only reason why I would go see this movie. I don't have any desire to see it. And definitely seeing them saying how, you know, we just basically find the seat of our pants with these you know, the way they're doing the improv and everything, plus the, everything else they're going, again, like I said, does not give me confidence going forward. So, how do y'all feel about that? And like I said, I will have the full article in my description box so you can, you know, check it out yourself, because it really is, you know, I don't want to beat a dead horse, but, you know, that's basically what this is about. It's like improv for episode 9. So, let me know how you feel about that. Like, share, and subscribe, and of course, hit that notification bell so you get my videos when I drop them. Catch you guys later. Peace. Yo, I swear you can't touch me. Like vampires with no Buffy, it's no show. No contest, put it to rest. You're out of your league.